Welcome back to Ned's Kitchen. Today we're going to cook a brisket, the point of the brisket. You know, we've had so much fun with these videos, and in particular the video with the whole grilled snapper has been a big success, particularly with all my new friends from Asia. They really seem to love that video. So today we're going to do something a little more American. We're going to cook a brisket. Now the brisket is a hard piece of meat to cook, and it's the toughest thing I've really ever cooked. But one thing I've discovered with that is you can take part of the brisket called the point, which is the part that usually you don't get in the store. And I've had this prepared for me here. As you can see, the point looks a little bit different. The meat fibers are running this way. And what you'll notice is that it has a lot of extra marbling. I think it helps to maintain better flavor and better moisture. And I think it just cooks better. But most people, you know, you go to the store and you see the flat of the brisket. Or if you get the whole brisket, you get both of those and you can kind of do it all together. But we're going to do just the point today. And we're going to start with this just to get I'm going to put a little rub on it. And to get to adhere, I'm going to spray a little olive oil, Pam on it. And then we're also going to put a rub on it. You can use any rub you like. I've kind of found this through trial and error, a rub that I like. It's a rub that I make myself. It has 4 tablespoons of ground pepper, 4 tablespoons of table salt, 2 teaspoons of garlic powder, 2 teaspoons of fresh ground cumin seed, and 1 teaspoon of red chili flake. And then I just kind of grind that all together in a spice grinder and then just put it in this for to make it easier to go on. So I'm going to put this on the meat. We're going to put this on both sides of the meat, and then we'll let it sit overnight and kind of take in some of that rub and then put it on tomorrow. So this will sit overnight. We're just going to kind of rub it in. And then we'll be good to go tomorrow. Okay. We're here at Harris Teeter with my favorite butcher, Steve Johnson. Steve, we're going to make some brisket this weekend. And we're going to use the point of the brisket. Can you tell the audience kind of the difference between the point and the flat?
Now the point has more marbling in it, which actually gives you much greater flavor. But you've got to treat the brisket with respect, or the disrespect you will put.
It sure will. I think it's the hardest cut of meat cut to cook.
Mr. Johnson makes some really great seasoning. You want to tell us a little about your seasoning?
Yeah, tell us about your seasoning.
Well, the seasoning was produced by my father back in 1974. We had our own butcher shop, Johnson's Meat Market. It's an all-purpose seasoning that goes on anything, vegetables, any kind of meat, salads, soups. Just don't put it on ice cream. I tried that. Something about.
Howdy. It's bright and early in the morning. The coffee's on. As you can see by my shirt, I pay tribute to the master of all things barbecue, Aaron Franklin. I can guarantee right now this barbecue will be not as good as Aaron Franklin's. If you want the best, go to Aaron Franklin. It is the best. But we're going to give it a good stab today and see how it works out. We'll get this fire going and we'll be outside in a little bit. In the meantime, I'll show you the barbecue smoker.
Well, it's bright and early on Easter morning, and we've got the chimney starter going there. I put that in with a little bit of the Wall Street Journal at the bottom. I like to use that. I think it gives a nice, fair, and balanced burn. And gets the chimney starter going really well. We'll let that get going and put it in with the smoker here once we get a good set of charcoal going. One problem with the Oklahoma Joe smoker is that the thermometer that comes with it is horribly inaccurate, and I'll show you a measurement of that later on as we start smoking. So while we're waiting for the coals to heat up, I thought I'd introduce you to my pit. We have here an Oklahoma Joe's horizontal offset smoker, and as you can see in the here's where the meat goes. I left the grill off here to show you a couple of features on it. A couple of things I've done, if you can see below there, I have lined the bottom with red bricks, which I think help to insulate the smoker and also help to maintain a consistent heat. As you can see also there's a diffuser which I got from Horizon that makes a similar style smoker, and as you can see it has larger holes on the left side and smaller holes on the right side. So as the heat comes in out of the smoke box here, the fire box, it helps to kind of diffuse that heat where the right close to the box that there are smaller holes and farther out larger holes. And I've added a little bent piece of 3-inch pipe there to help kind of direct the smoke out the other end also. Got a little aluminum foil down the bottom there, and the reason for that is just that it helps to catch the fat and makes cleanup a little easier. Here over on the firebox side, you can see in the grate, put a little aluminum foil below that too, and also line that on either side with the bricks, as you can see there, which I think helps to kind of retain the heat also, and also helps on the end here where the air comes in. It helps to kind of dampen that a little bit so you get you can control the airflow a little bit better. So we'll be smoking here in a few minutes once we get these charcoal briquettes heated up and ready to go. So our charcoal's ready, and I've dropped it in the charcoal basket here over on the fire side. Got that basket, interestingly, from charcoalbasket.com, which is in Franklin, Tennessee. So we'll give this a few minutes, let the smoker start to heat up. Okay, the coals have been on for about 20 minutes, and you can see the temperature on the Oklahoma Joes is reading about 150. However, if we look here on the Maverick internal temperature, we're right at about 217, which is almost ready to go. So as they say in Breaking Bad, let's get cooking. Well, we're cooking right along here at about 221 degrees. We want a target temperature of somewhere between 225 and 250, and we seem to be right on the money here. So you can see we have the charcoal basket full with nice gray coals there, and I've added on top of that some hunks of oak wood. We'll use some oak and some, maybe a little bit of hickory today also. All right, it's time to cook. We've got our meat on here. As I've got a little bonus presentation for you too. As you'll see, we'll have two brisket points here. And also in the back and on the far edge there, I've got two racks of baby back ribs. So we're going to take this meat and we're going to spray it with apple juice just to kind of keep it a little moist and maybe help with a little caramelization on top of it. And then we're going to put the wood chips on, wood chunks rather on, and get cooking. You can see here after a couple of hours the base of charcoal starts to burn down, so I progressively just add maybe 10 or 12 hunks of charcoal every hour or so, and then add on some wood and mix in there with it. As I mentioned earlier, we're cooking with oak today. That's usually my wood of preference. It's easy to get, and it gets a nice clean burn to it. It tastes really good. If I can get pecan, I really like that, but it's hard to find. But gosh, it really smells great. And then sometimes we use hickory too, just kind of depending on the preference. But we're cooking along here and getting a good clean burn, as you can see. Things are going well. Okay, smoking along. It's been about an hour. About once an hour, I like to come back in, put a little more apple juice on top, get a good little spray on them there. Getting plenty of good smoke, as you can see. We're cooking along here, as you can see, looking pretty good. It's been about 3 hours now. Gonna give it a little spray here again with some apple juice. And as you can see also, I've put some sausages in there. Let those smoke up a little bit too. We should have quite a bit of cue here when it comes to be dinner time. Well, we've got a full head of smoke coming out now, and usually what that means is the temperature is going to be dropped a little bit. As you can see there, it's come down to about 201, and we need to kind of stir the fire. It's smoldering up a little bit inside. So it's been maybe 5 minutes, and you can see there the temperature is coming back up now. We've got an internal temperature on the meat of 145, 217 in the smoker, and you can see how the smoke is clearing up now. So we just kind of stirred that up a little bit. Some of the charcoal and wood hunks were smoldering a little bit. Now they're burning clean. These have been smoking about 6 hours now. They pretty much got as much smoke as they're going to take. So what we're going to do is wrap them in foil here, also known as the Texas crutch, and wrap them up. And we're going to put them in the oven at 225 and let them finish there at a constant temperature. We're about 6 hours into the cook. We're in a period now what's called the stall. And when this happens, you'll notice it'll be a long period of time where nothing really happens for a while with the temperature. And what's going on there is the collagen and the connective tissue are starting to just kind of melt down and get real tender. Then you'll notice after a while, maybe at about 180 or so, 170, 180, the temperature will start picking up again until we get to our target range of about 190. As you can see, the brisket and ribs, they've been wrapped in foil and placed in the oven at a constant 225 degrees. And it's now about 430. And the internal temperature of the brisket is now 190 degrees, so it should be done. We're going to let it rest until everyone gets here, and then we'll cut it up, and hopefully it tastes real good.
All right, first up, we're going to slice a little of the ribs here, see how they turned out.
Well, I mean, we had plenty of
wine, where's your bottle of wine? Is this yours?
All right, this looks like it's going to be good.
Nothing glad about that, so.
Oh, really?
Then we'll get to the brisket here in just a second. Cut.
Part of one of his articles, we went to Red Notre Dame a few weekends ago, and I was doing a speech for my
gown,
and I used his quote to the survey. If I, I'm sure
we're
going to
need well, nice and juicy in here. All right, so the fibers are running this way, so we want to cut across. So I'm going to cut it in half first. Here we are with our tasting panel. We've had our barbecue for the night, and beef aficionado Bert is here. Bert, your thoughts about the barbecue tonight?
Well, it ain't no Franklin's barbecue, but I did go back and have three helpings, so that should say something.
I did like his brisket again this time.
Meredith?
I thought the brisket was excellent. I do have to say I was surprised and pleased with the rib. It made me want to lick the bone.
Nothing says spring like the beautiful phlox blooming out in the yard and the smell of smoked meat. That was a really good feed. We really enjoyed that brisket and happy to do that for everyone for Easter too. It's about as good a brisket as I've made, but I can always do better. It's a great thing about brisket. It's always a challenge. There's always a opportunity to improve on it. I think we'll do even better next time, but so far it's pretty good. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe to my channel.